Thank you. First of all, let me just say that I think it is disgusting that we have colleagues on this hearing who won't acknowledge black women's suffering, that there are stark differences in our pain. But St. Louis, and I thank you, Chairwoman Maloney and Congresswoman Kelly, for your leadership in convening this all-important hearing. It is an honor to join my sisters in service, Congresswoman Presley, Underwood, and Adams, as part of today's panel. I sit here before you as a mother, a single mother of two. Zion, my eldest child, was born at 23 weeks gestation versus what is considered a normal pregnancy at 40 weeks. When I was early in my pregnancy with him, I didn't think that there could even be a possibility that there could be a complication. I became sick during my pregnancy. I had hyperemesis gravidarum, which was severe nausea and vomiting. I was constantly throwing up for the first 4 months of my pregnancy. Around 5 months, I went to see my doctor for a routine prenatal visit. As I was sitting in the doctor's office, I noticed a picture on the wall that said, "If you feel like something is wrong, tell your doctor." I felt like something was wrong, so that's what I did. I told my doctor, I told her that I was having severe pains, and she said, "Oh no, you're fine. You're fine, go home, and I'll see you next time." So that's what I did, I went home. 1 week later, I went into preterm labor. At 23 weeks, my son was born, 1 pound, 3 ounces. His ears were still in his head, his eyes were still fused shut, his fingers were smaller than rice, and his skin was translucent, a black baby, translucent skin. You could see his lungs. He could fit within the palm of my hand. We were told he had a 0% chance of life. The chief of neonatal surgery happened to be in the hospital that morning and saw my case on the surgical board, and she decided to try to resuscitate him. It worked, and for the first month of his life, Zion was on a ventilator fighting to live. For 4 months, he was in the neonatal care unit. The doctor who delivered my son apologized. She said, "You were right, and I didn't listen to you. Give me another chance." 2 months later, I was pregnant again, so I went back to her. At 16 weeks, I went for an ultrasound at the clinic and saw a different doctor who was working that day. I found out again, I was in preterm labor. The doctor told me that the baby was going to abort. I said, "No, you have to do something," but he was adamant and he said, "Just go home, let it abort. You can get pregnant again because that's what you people do." My sister Kelly was with me. We didn't know what to do after the doctor left. So we saw a chair sitting in the hallway. My sister picked up the chair and she threw it down the hallway. Nurses came running from everywhere to see what was wrong. A nurse called my doctor and she put me on a stretcher. The next morning, my doctor came in and placed a cerclage on my uterus, and I was able to carry my baby. My daughter, my angel, who is now 20 years old, my son, who was saved, is now 21 years old. This is what desperation looks like, that chair flying down a hallway. This is what being your own advocate looks like. Every day, black women are subjected to harsh and racist treatment during pregnancy and childbirth. Every day, black women die because the system denies our humanity. It denies us patient care. I sit before you today as a single mom, as a nurse, as an activist, and as a congresswoman, and I am committed to doing the absolute most to protect black mothers, to protect black babies, to protect black birthing people, and to save lives. Thank you, and I yield back.